count these goods and services. Now you may wonder that is it possible to count these thousands kinds of goods and services? How is it possible to do it? We know that thousands of goods and services are produced. Now how to count them? Okay, now actually you may wonder, but there is a very good procedure. Now, can we count or add all these goods? Suppose wheat 1,000 kg. Suppose it that 1,000 kg. Okay, then suppose this is the season of mango. Suppose at 100 kg. Okay, then suppose computer, it is 500, 50, okay, or 50, 500 pieces, 500 pieces, all right. Suppose similarly, cars, it may be 1,000 pieces. Now, can we add them? Is it possible to add these things? No, it is not possible. How can we add kg with piece? Or again, say cloth. Suppose cloth. Suppose it is 100 meters. Now, can we add the kg with pieces and pieces with meter? It is not possible. So, what is the solution? Now, so question, what is the question? Question is that how to count these goods and services? Answer is, it is not possible to count and add these thousands types of goods and services. It is not possible to count and add. I have written on the board. See, is it possible? No, it is not possible. Then what is the solution? Solution is that we have to found answer. I am writing on the top. Okay, we have to find the values. We have to find the values of these goods and services. Okay, we have to these goods and services. Okay, we have to. So, my dear students, you will have to remember this thing, that how to count. Answer is, we have to find the values of these goods and services. We have to find the values. Okay, each and everything has market price. Each and everything has a market price. So, what is required is that we can multiply the number with the price per unit. We can multiply the number or amount or quantity by the price of these goods. Okay, now you see, suppose wheat at the rate of 20 per kg. Okay, mango at the rate of 50 per kg. Okay, computer at the rate of 50,000 per piece. Okay, cars at the rate of 5 lakh per piece. Okay, cloth at the rate of 100 per meter. Okay, now if we market price, we know, so the rates, it is easy for us to know the rates. Now if we multiply, okay, the number of quantity with the price, with the rate, it is easy for us to get it. Now let me rub it. Now you see, and then into 20
Squall to you see 20,000. Okay, 20,000. All right. Now I go 50 into 50 is equal to 5,000. 5,000. Okay. Now computer, you see. Oh my God. Now 500. 25, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Yes. You see, here two zeros, and here 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 zeros. So you see, yes. Yes. We have got it. Now, 5 lakh cars. Okay, 5 lakh, lakh. So 1,000 into 5 lakh. Into 5 lakh. Okay. In this, that is 5,000 lakhs. Okay. 5,000 lakhs. Similar, 100 piece cloth into 100 is equal to be 10,000. 10,000. Yes. Calculation, that doesn't matter at all. I only want to show you that how to count. So let us start from the beginning. That it is how to count these goods and services. This is the question. Answer is, it is not possible to count different types of goods and services and add them. It is not possible. So what to do? Here, answer is here, that we have to find the values of those goods and services. How can we know the value? How can we know the value? The per unit price we know, market price we know. So if we multiply the total number or quantity by the unit price, price per unit, we can easily get the. Now we can add it. We can add it. Okay. So answer is okay. You have already got the answer that we have to find the values of goods and services. That is the answer here. Okay, now let me rub out. Yes. Now, one precaution is there. Let me write here. One precaution. One precaution. While counting, while counting and adding or finding the final values, finding the values of these goods and services, we have one precaution. What is the precaution? What is the precaution that we should have to take? We must have to know it. What is the precaution? That we have to count. We have to find values of final goods and services. Final goods and services. What I have written? That we have to find values of final goods and services. Final. Just. Okay. This thing you must have to the circle. Final goods and services. Okay. What are final goods? What are final goods? The goods. Goods that we consume. Goods that we can consume are called final goods, okay? For example, you see, let me give you one example so that you can easily understand it. Now, suppose farmers produce wheat, okay, or cotton.
flowers, so many other things are there. Now, can we consume or eat wheat? No, we cannot do it. Okay? So wheat is turned into flour. Wheat is turned into flour. Even we cannot eat flour. Then what we'll have to do? Flour into bread or biscuit. Bread or biscuit. Okay? So as we cannot eat wheat, as we cannot eat flour, raw flour, it is not possible. But as we can eat bread, so bread or biscuit, okay, bread or biscuit is the final good. Okay? Bread or biscuit is the final good. Understand the matter? Bread or biscuit is the final good. So what are final goods? Final goods are that which we can consume or which we can eat. We'll consume, not only eat. Now everything we do not eat. You see, another example is here. Yes, cotton. Now, can we put on cotton? No, we cannot put on cotton. So, cotton is turned into yarn. Okay? Then yarn is turned into cloth. Yes. We can use cloth. Alright? You see? Oh. Now see, 100 meters of cloth can we wear? No. Then, thong cloth, pant. Or shirt, okay, pant or shirt or salwar or kameez or any other thing that we show. Here you see that pant, shirt or kameez, these are the final goods. Understand the matter? Okay, then what are these things? That is wheat, flour, okay, all these things. Let me write here on the top. Now you see that. Wheat, flour, these are called cotton, yarn, cloth, okay? These are called intermediate goods. These are called intermediate goods. Okay? So, what is the answer? That we must have to find the values of final goods and services. What are final goods? What are final goods? The goods. Goods that we can consume, can enjoy. Okay? Are called final goods. The other stages are called intermediate goods. Okay, intermediary goods. Okay, so why not the intermediate goods? Why only final goods? Why not intermediate goods? That is another question. Now, so the question is why final goods? Why final goods? Ask me. Why have we to find out? Why do we have to find out final goods? And not intermediary goods? Because final goods, answer, let me write here. Final goods, okay? Final goods, values of final goods already include. Values of intermediate goods. Yes, intermediate goods. You see, my dear, that why do we come final goods? Why do we have to final goods and not other goods? Because values of final goods already include the values of intermediate goods. For example, you see, bread. Now value of bread already includes the value of
flour or wheat.
Okay, You see that if we add both values of final goods and also intermediary goods, there will be double counting. There will be double counting. So why do we count? Answer is to avoid double counting. To avoid double counting. To avoid double counting. This is the answer. To avoid double counting. Because values of final goods already include the value of intermediary goods. Okay? Now the last topic. Today's last topic is GDP. GDP. I'll explain it. GDP. Okay? Let me pass on to the next video.